been in works, they deny him. But we need to remember that obedience, catch this, okay? Obedience ought always to be connected to a personal relationship we enjoy with our Savior and Lord. It's not out of fear. It's not out of fright. It's not out of duty. It's out of a personal relationship. He said to the disobedient who did not sort all of sorts of things in his name, I never knew you. So you can obey, but it has to be, they lack the personal relationship. That's what evangelicalism is. That's what makes us different than mainline, a lot of mainline churches or other, even other religions. They lack the personal relationship. But to be obedient, Jesus promised, anyone who loves me will obey my teachings. My Father will love them. And we will come to them and make our home with them. It's a relationship. We should always link obedience with our personal love for Jesus. Now, I'm going to give you an illustration that's greatly flawed. So, just hang in there with me. I do have a point. Let's suppose a young woman takes a job as a housekeeper and cook for a young bachelor. Bachelors don't get any ideas here, okay? He gives her a list of tasks that he expects her to do, cleaning the house, fixing his meals at certain times, stuff like that. She performs those tasks in a satisfactory manner as an employee. But then the two of them fall in love and get married. And then, yes, I know she just changed the color of her hair. She now may have to do many of the same tasks, but she does them out of a relationship of love, not of sheer duty. Do you get the point? That illustration should frustrate some of you women. So if it does, just imagine that you have a single working woman who hires a bachelor to come do the housekeeping and cooking in your house. Does that sound better? Yeah, it can go either way. To follow Jesus means a continual obedience to Christ as Lord, but obedience in the context of knowing and loving him as our bridegroom and Savior. His life, who gave his life so that we could live with him both now and in eternity. Obedience is a natural result of love, voluntarily in nature, not something brought on by force or fear. Maybe you're thinking, this self-denial sounds so negative. In the short term, self-denial is difficult and not pleasant, but there are eternal blessings in store. When you follow Jesus on the path of the cross, if you're following Jesus, he'll always take you to the cross. When you die to self and follow Jesus, he graciously gives you the ultimate in fulfillment as the byproduct, the joy of eternal life and being affirmed by Jesus before the Father when he comes in glory. In Luke 9:23, it's pretty clear. Living for self means that you're not following Jesus. There are not two tracks to take as a Christian, where you choose the normal Christian life or the discipleship or lordship track. Don't be deceived. The self-centered track eventually runs out. So give it careful thought, but don't take too long. Luke 9:23, and he said to them all, if anyone would come after me, they must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. Are you all in? There's only one train, and it's leaving the station. I hope you get on it. I guarantee you it'll be the ride of your life. I know, because it has been for me over the last 50 years. All aboard. Let me pray with you. Dear Lord, open our eyes and minds and hearts to embrace Jesus as both Lord and Savior. From today on, might we daily die to self and openly live committed, Christ-centered lives, closely following you for your glory. Amen. Okay. Worship team.
Let's follow that. Excuse me. Let's follow that. In singing together, I surrender all. You stand and sing with us, please.
All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him, in his presence daily live. I surrender all. All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender. To Jesus I surrender, humbly at his feet I fall. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now. I surrender all. Savior, I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender. Make me, Savior, wholly thine. Let me feel the Holy Spirit. Truly know that thou art mine. I surrender all. All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all.
All to Jesus I surrender. Lord, I give myself to thee. Fill me with thy love and power. Let thy blessings fall on me. I surrender all. All to Jesus, blessed Savior, I surrender.
Go out into your neighborhoods, your communities, your businesses, your ministries, by committed thought, word, and action, proclaiming Jesus as both Savior and Lord.